we can apply VSEPR theory systematically to the interior atoms of a larger molecule to determine its overall shape. For example, the organic molecule glycine has 4 interior atoms. Remember that interior atoms are bonded to 2 or more other atoms. We can apply VSEPR theory to determine the molecular geometry around each of the 4 interior atoms. For nitrogen, we have 3 bonding groups and 1 lone pair, so the molecular geometry is trigonal pyramidal. For the leftmost carbon, we have 4 bonding groups and no lone pairs, so the molecular geometry is tetrahedral. For the rightmost carbon, we have 3 bonding groups and no lone pairs, so the molecular geometry is trigonal planar. And for the oxygen atom, we have 2 bonding groups and 2 lone pairs, so the molecular geometry is bent. Applying the molecular geometry at each atom allows us to envision the structure three-dimensionally. We can apply VSEPR theory at each interior atom to as large of a molecule as we want. For example, let's determine the molecular geometry at each of the 4 atoms in red in this organic molecule. For the carbon on the left, we have 3 bonding groups and no lone pairs. This produces a trigonal planar geometry. In fact, all of the carbons in the fused rings have a trigonal planar geometry. So these rings are flat, having all of the atoms on the same plane. Next, we can look at the oxygen atom. It has 2 bonding groups and 2 lone pairs, so it has a bent molecular geometry. For the nitrogen atom, it has 3 bonding groups and 1 lone pair, so it has a trigonal pyramidal molecular geometry. And for the carbon on the right, it has 4 bonding groups and no lone pairs, so it has a tetrahedral molecular geometry. Determining the molecular geometry at each of the interior atoms allows us to piece together the overall structure of the molecule propranolol.